Hello everyone. In this video we're going to take a look at our raw sequence data, the SFF file we got now, and how to convert this using SFF extract to a faster file which you can import into Genius. Also, we will apply some quality clipping. The SFF file does include some information about the sequence quality and also some suggested clipping sites. So you need to imagine the sequence starts and till the end of the sequence, the quality usually decreases. And the 444 sequencer suggests you some clipping parts where it says, okay, at this point we should clip the tail of the sequence away because it has poor quality. You could think about keeping the complete sequence, but this is kind of a little bit dodgy if you want to publish your results. I mean, you can get some more sequence information if you assembly them together, you see which parts are right and which parts are wrong and have a lot of errors. But to have a really clear data set, it's the best to apply quality clipping and have very restrictive data. So be a little bit more conservative with your data. Also, when we are using the script, now it's time we really write things in our lab notebook. Documentation is really, really important. Personally, I prefer to write everything in here with a pen on paper. But for us in the tutorial, I will do this on a document in the computer. I don't like this because you could change things around and it's not really a clear documentation because you can edit wherever you want and it's not that chronologically. So I will still keep it and just do addings on the bottom and don't change things above. So yeah, I will provide this lab notes which we are making throughout the course later as a PDF when we have finished all the videos. But now let's get right into extracting our FASTR files from our SFF files. We have here our basic SFF files. So SFF stands for Standard Flowgram Format. And we need to extract the information out of those raw sequence files. I just wanted to point out that I will not provide those files directly to you as sample data because they're quite large. So this is almost 300 megabytes big. I will give you the FASTR files which you can put directly into Genius because the process we're doing now is relatively easy and there's not really a point if you download all the data, it just takes a long time. You can just directly take the FASTR files. First of all, we need to download the script to extract our files. You find the link in the YouTube description below. To save the script, click on download here and on SFF extract 3.0. Here you can click on File, Save Page As, and we're going to save this one as a PY file, and we save it for now on the desktop. Click on Save, and now we put this file into our folder to our raw data. All right, when I run some scripts and manipulate some data with the terminal, for example, I always open a little notepad document. And in here, I write some information, for example, always the date, and then roughly what I have done with those few commands. Let's also make this a little bit bigger. Okay, now we can go to our manual. And in here, we're just going to copy the sample we have in here. Let's go back to our text document and we paste it in here. We now have to change some things because this example is still for the coral, Favia, and we want to extract Dinocras. So we go to our Dinocras SFF and you can directly copy the name and we paste it in here. Then, of course, we also want to change the name of the files we are creating. So this minus O gives the name for the complete output here. So we call this one Dino No Clipping and Dino Clipping. The clipping is activated by adding a minus C. Of course, we need to have the right working dictionary. This is already correct. But if you want to set it up on your computer, you can right-click on the file, get info, and copy the location of your file directly from here. Now we can basically run this thing. If you don't have your terminal in your bar over here, you can click on Applications, and normally under Utilities, you will find your terminal. Click on it to start it. And then we're simply going to copy the things we have written in here into the terminal. Let's start with this one here. This will change the working dictionary. So if I type now ls, I can check if I'm in the right folder. So I have here my dinocross, sff, and also the script. With this command here, we will execute the script. In this case, I just will copy both and run them in here. It takes some minutes. Let's take a look also at the folder, what is happening. All right, now it's done converting all the sequences, and we also did get the first information about our data set. We have roughly 90,000 sequences in the 454 data. We have created now a clipped version and one with no clipping. This is just to take a look at it, how the data looks when it's not clipped, but I will provide you with the dinocross data which is clipped. So this is the data which you also can download and use to follow along with this tutorial. Next, we can take this data into Genius, and we can also use FastQC to look at the data and get a quick idea what the sequence quality of the 454 dataset is. So let's do that next. But before we are doing that, we will take a quick look in our lab notebook and make some documentation. So here we have now written our commands, which we used quickly what we did do. And I always add also the day. So this is Saturday today, because sometimes you can get a typo in your date. And I quickly add that this will be the final file. So if you want, you can continue to the next part of this tutorial.